Shabbat Shalom. I wish to biblically address the unspeakable American Holocaust taking place in our beloved country. Though 50 to 60 million babies are killed in the wombs of their mothers worldwide, this enlightened country has murdered 55 million little unborn ones that were aborted through their entire 9 months. Since the January 22, 1973, Roe versus Wade and Doe versus Bolton Supreme Court decisions that made abortion legal. Statistics are staggering. 1.5 million U.S. abortions each year. Every third baby conceived in the United States of America is killed in the womb by his mother. Our future military, teachers, doctors, fathers, and mothers, gone. Daily, 4,000 unborn babies are aborted in the United States. 170 babies each hour. And Planned Parenthood, the major U.S. abortion provider, kills one baby every 95 seconds. Unfortunately, our tax dollars paid them to do this. Between 2009 and 2010, almost $1.5 billion went to them from our tax dollars. And that is, they are continued to be included in the Obamacare to receive millions and millions of our tax money. Margaret Sanger, a devout racist against blacks and Jews, founded Planned Parenthood to reduce the U.S. population of colored people by black genocide and sterilization. She said, quote, "Colored people are like human weeds and are to be exterminated." That's exactly what Hitler believed about the Jews. My relatives in Poland have sought their extermination, since my mother and father were both immigrants from Poland. I spoke a few days ago with Martin Luther King's niece, Dr. Alveda King, who had had several abortions herself, for which she has repented. Presidential election TV ads still declare that Martin Luther King promoted abortion. Dr. King told me that is a lie, that he was against it. He said, quote, "The Negro cannot win as long as he is willing to sacrifice the lives of his children for comfort and safety." Though African Americans comprise only 13% of the U.S. population, they have 35% of all abortions in the U.S., highest of any racial group. 43% of all women in the United States have had abortions, based on polls. 47% of these women have repeats. It is legal to do here to an unborn baby what you might be arrested for if you did it to a dog or a cat. The suicide rate of those who have had abortions escalates to 400 to 800%. Contrary to some presidential election TV ads which state that Planned Parenthood clinics give mammograms to screen women for breast cancer, not one mammogram is found in any of the American clinics of Planned Parenthood. Their main revenue is performing abortions covered by our tax money. King David in Psalm 139 writes, "You have formed me in my inward parts. You have woven me in my mommy's womb. I will praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows very well. My bones were not hidden from you. Your eyes saw my substance, being yet unformed. And in your book they are all written, the days fashioned for me, when as yet there was none of them. God knew you at the moment of conception." According to that verse, but there were no days yet in your life. See this football player on Sports Illustrated? Tim Tebow. His mother was in a coma in the Philippine Islands as a missionary to orphanages with her husband. She didn't know she was pregnant. They found it while she was in the coma. She had dysentery, and they gave her very strong medications, which appeared was killing the baby, preventing oxygen from reaching his brain. Every doctor, the top doctors in the Philippine Islands for 7 months told her, to save your life, you must abort this baby. He'll be stillborn. They badgered her, you must abort this baby. She loved Yeshua, Jesus. She homeschooled all four children. He was the baby, Tim. And what came out of her womb? She promised God we'll call him Timothy, after Timothy in the Bible, and we'll raise him to be a preacher. They were astounded. And this 6'3", 250-pound Heisman Trophy winner is the result. No brain damage, pure muscle. Is he a preacher? Saturday Night Live loves to mock him. And I was watching some interviews, and they were talking about laughing at him. He believes in abstinence, no sex outside of marriage. Isn't that ridiculous? And after they finished laughing, they looked at each other and said, "But isn't that the kind of boy you'd like to have your daughter bring home to meet?" And they all agreed. He puts black on his cheekbones. Remember the mother said, "We're going to make him a preacher?" He puts John 3:16. And when the camera zoomed on his face, it is reported by a source that Google, 90 million people Googled John 3:16. He was preaching from his cheekbones. And what does John 3:16 say? "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." I was invited to Berlin, Germany, to stand where Adolf Hitler stood in the Olympic Stadium and made his final, his big declaration. "I have the final solution to the world's problems. Let's kill all the Jews in the world." I was invited to come there to sing and to speak, asking for reconciliation and repentance of the Germans and the other nations represented. My mother, Golda, from Poland, was with me. We flew to Munich, Hitler's headquarters, and busted to Dachau, the concentration camp. I didn't know what God had in store for me there. I researched their literature and saw there was still a cover-up of what they had fully done to the Jewish people in that camp. And I said, "I've got to see the baby ovens. I've got to see where some of over 1 million Jewish babies and infants and toddlers were incinerated." And I went and stood in front of the baby oven and had my camera. Just as I was ready to click it, God spoke to me as if in an audible voice. He said this, The picture you are taking of the oven in which many of my little ones were incinerated are identical to the abortion clinics in America, and I almost dropped my candle. I was in shock. Upon returning to America, I began to write articles on the American Holocaust with the picture of the baby oven and piles of worn old shoes that they had taken from the Jews who were murdered in the camps. Later, God led me to design a car magnet. Which I prayed would jolt people when they saw it on any vehicle. Because it says at the top, you never wear a glob of tissue. That is what each worker at Planned Parenthood is instructed to tell the women that come in there to get have their babies aborted. It's not a baby. It's just a glob of tissue. As I placed my first order for this bumper sticker, the male customer service representative said it filled his computer screen. And he gasped, and there was dead silence. I asked, "Sir, are you all right?" He responded by saying, "Is that in the Bible?" And I said, "Yes, and there are many more Bible verses on the same subject." He responded, "Oh my God, this has changed the direction of my life." Didn't ask him how many abortions he had paid for, or how many girls he got pregnant. What confirmation from the Lord that this design was from him. These are nailed both downstairs after the service. The authority of the Word of God is critical in understanding the horrors God sees in this medical procedure for death. I love this Luke 2. The angel Gabriel appears to the Virgin Miriam, her Hebrew name for Mary. She was going to have a son, and his name would be Yeshua. Yeshua is Hebrew for Jesus. And her elderly relative, Elizabeth, had conceived a son 6 months old. Miriam went running to the hill country, into the house, and the baby, 6 months in her womb, leapt with joy at the sound of the mother of Yeshua. A glob of tissue does not leap for joy. A living human being leaps for joy. When this baby was circumcised on the eighth day, he was named Yohanan, John. Yeshua said, "Of those born of women, there was not a greater prophet than John." I wish to present to you an unborn child, because most babies are killed in the womb the first 12 weeks, as this baby personifies. The diary of an unborn child. Today, my life began. My parents don't know it. I'm as small as a seed in the apple. But I'm here already. And I'm to be a girl. I shall have blonde hair and blue eyes. And just about everything is settled. Even though I would love flowers. Week 2. Some say that I'm not a real person. That only my mommy exists, but I am a real person. And just as a small crumb of bread is really bread, my mommy is, and I am. Week 3. My mouth is just beginning to open now. Just think,
gently eat for the rest of my life without ever stopping to rest. And after many years, it will stop. And then I shall die. Fifthly, I'm growing a bit every day. My arms and my legs are beginning to take shape. But I have to wait a long time. Yet before these little legs will hold me and raise me up to my mommy's arms. And I can gather flowers with them and embrace my daddy. Week six. Tiny feathers are beginning to form on my hands. Funny how small they are. I'll be able to stroke my mommy's hair, bright and shiny. Week seven. It wasn't until today that the doctor told mommy that I'm living here under her heart. Oh, how happy you must be, mommy. Are you happy? Week eight. My mommy and daddy are probably thinking about a name for me. Not even knowing I'm a little girl. I want to be called Esther. I'm getting so big already. Week nine. My hair is growing. It's smooth and bright. Oh, exciting. Week 10. In a few weeks, I will be able to see. It's dark around me. When mommy brings me into the world, it will be full of sunshine and flowers. But what I want more than anything is to see my mommy. 11 weeks. I wonder if mommy hears the whispering of my heart. Oh, some children come into the world a little sick. But my heart is strong and healthy. It beats so evenly. Tup, 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 tup. You'll have a healthy little daughter, mommy. Week 12. This since Roe versus Wade. And I felt this week, I know there's people here who have had abortions. I know there's men here that have helped contribute to that. And I think we need to ask the Lord to forgive us if this has been part of our history, and not to let this go without dealing with it. Let's pray to the Father, the author of every life. Heavenly Dad, I ask, Lord, if there is anyone here this morning who has had an abortion or has encouraged or insisted on another person to have one, or as a male have contributed to an unwanted pregnancy, that they would come to you with a contrite heart this morning and ask for the blood of the Messiah Israel to cover those sins as they repent before you. We ask, Lord, for you to forgive and wash us clean with the precious blood of the Lamb of God, Yeshua, our Passover Lamb, and cause us to know that we truly are forgiven and have repented of that lifestyle. Forgive us for any encouragement we have been to terminate an unwanted pregnancy. We know there are thousands desiring to adopt a child, but there are not enough babies available in the United States. Heal and deliver us and forgive us, Lord. We're supposed to be an enlightened society. In some ways, we're no better than the Nazis were. to your Jewish people be incinerated in gas ovens. Help us to speak up for those who cannot speak for themselves, the little ones, tucked away in their mother's wombs. Empower these pregnant mothers to carry these little ones to full term and bless them with your salvation as they do this. We love you, Abba, Daddy. Help us to love you more perfectly. In Yeshua's name. And all God's people say, Amen.
I plead your blood over my sins and the sins of my nation. I plead your blood.